How we doing, everybody? I am back with another video. Today I'm going to be showing you a new iOS app that I created using Xcode and SpriteKit, and I'm going to be going through the process of actually how it was made, showing you the steps really of how I went about it. After I got bored of playing the most amazing and legendary app, Swipe Soccer, made by yours truly here at Flopperam, I decided it was time for a change, to switch it up, so we made a new app just to play in our free time, and we're hoping that you guys like it too and want to download it and check it out. Before we get into the details of the video, I just wanted to say if you are not subscribed to the channel, please do us a favor, hit that subscribe button. According to our analytics, actually 82% of you guys who are viewing this video are not subscribed to our channel, and that's just actually crazy. If you hit that subscribe button, it really helps us make more tutorials and videos for the channel. It motivates us to do more, so we really appreciate everyone who subscribed, and will also hit that subscribe button. So first, I can describe the main menu and end screens that were built. They are relatively simple. I have my custom background image that I made using Photoshop, and then created three different nodes for the instructions of the game, giving them a set font, a size, and location to be put on the screen. The last part of the code, where I have the touches begin function, it will move to the game scene once the node named start game is clicked. The game over scene has a very similar implementation than the main menu screen. Again, a few nodes for the text with given sizes and locations, and a touch begin function to initiate a change of screen when clicking the start button or the exit button. Clicking the restart button will simply bring you back to the game for another game, and the exit button will bring you back to the main menu screen. Now moving on to the actual game screen. Here is where all the code for the game mechanics were actually made. You can see here I'm actually coding the function that will be spawning a new disc every single time. I create a variable to hold a random number 1 through 4. That variable gets passed into the node that declares which object to be spawned, giving it a random number allowing one of the four circles to actually spawn. I then give it an area to spawn in and simply add the child. We then have a working implementation of the circles spawning randomly. The functions for spawning the gold and the bomb are structured very similar, with a few small differences. There's only one object of each, so I will not have to create a random number for them to spawn at. I actually do have to make a randomness of how much they spawn. Here, as you can see, I have a function called keepScore. This is basically four small if statements saying once a certain score is reached, call spawn new disk, which will then tell the game to spawn another circle. The most circles that can be on a screen at one time is 5, and that happens when you reach a score of 175. And that might not seem that high, but trust me, once you reach over 125 mark, and there are 4 circles spawning all at once along with the gold and the bombs, it gets very difficult. My own record is actually only 181 at the time I am recording this, and I would love to see you guys try and beat it. If you do, please tweet us a picture of you playing or post in the comments what you guys get for high scores and see if you can beat me. But anyways, after calling the keepScore function to keep track of how many circles are to be spawning, I create two variables called randomGold and randomBomb. I implement them by saying create a random number for whatever the current score is, +4 and +2. Now doing this will make the game spawn the bombs and gold in random increments every single game. So technically, you could have a game where a bomb never even spawns once. Now this would be a crazy possibility. Or you could even have a game where a bomb is spawning almost every single score increase. It creates randomness and more fun for each time you play. I tried doing only +2 with the bomb, but I believe that was making it too difficult for the user, since a bomb was spawning quite significantly. So I then changed it to +5 from the score to allow a little less amount of bombs to spawn to allow the user to be able to get a higher score and make the game more playable and less hard. The main meat of this program really happens in this touches begin function. This starts off the game and controls the mechanics. It keeps track of the current score when a circle, a bomb, or a gold object is clicked by the user. It calls the sound effects for each object and also has the spam control functionality.
in it to say if no object is clicked at all, then take -1 points away from the score. Lastly, in the function, it has the high score tracker, so if you were to beat your current high score, it replaces your old high score and keeps it in your game forever until you beat it again.
One of our friends who tested the game the other day when it was just put up on the App Store gave us some good feedback that I never really thought about, but let me know in the comments what you think. He suggested that we add some opacity to the circles so you're able to see through them. So when a circle spawns on top of another one, you'll be able to see the one below. But I'm not sure because that's also what makes the game really difficult. So let me know in the comments what you think. Should I add some opacity to the circles in the next update? Should I just leave it as it is because it makes the game hard for the user? Let me know what you think.
So that is the quick rundown of our new game, Loot Collector. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want me to go into a detailed coding tutorials on how different aspects of the game were made, please let me know because we are looking into doing possibly some scene kit tutorials about specific features in the future. If you want to download the game and try and beat my high score, check the link in the description or go onto the App Store and look up Loot Collector. We really appreciate everyone who tries out the game and all the support as usual. If you like the video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you and have a great day as always.